Hey there. Have you been hearing all the buzz about people moving out of certain states like New York and Connecticut and taking up residency in other states like Florida? Well, hi there. I'm Judy Heft. I'm a financial concierge, and we work with personal bookkeeping to help people stay on track and stay organized with their own personal finances. And you know what? I'm hearing a lot about this. Of course, it's in the news, as you all know, too, but I just want to give you some tips on how to handle it. Because just registering and declaring your domicile in another state isn't really going to cut it. So here's some of the things that I think you need to know. You have to spend at least 183 days in your new residence. And you can't just get a post office box and think, okay, well, I live there now. No, it doesn't work that way. You have to either buy or rent a home and really put down your roots. It's really important because you know what? Easy Pass is tracking you, your cell phone records are available. There's all kinds of ways the IRS can know if you're telling the truth. So the first thing you should do, or the second thing you do after you establish your permanent residency, is some states like Florida want you to establish a domicile declaration. And that's an easy thing to do as long as you are committed to living in that home. Sometimes these are people that have two homes and they want to keep their primary home, but they want to pretend that their other home is their primary home now. So now you have to go around and switch everything. So here are some of the things I think you should do. Make sure that you're not working in that former state, that you're not receiving income, that your W-2 doesn't show that you've spent a lot of time working there. Register with the IRS. Go on there and change your address permanently with the IRS, and then file your tax returns in the new state. Register your car, go to the DMV. And register your car at your new home address. And while you're there, get your driver's license changed. That's a good way to prove that you're living in that state. Go to the library, get a library card, and make sure you're paying that taxes for that particular state. Get it all organized so that's what you're doing. Another thing to do and to remember is to go open a new checking account as a resident in the new state that you want to be living in. So that way, all your statements will have those addresses on them, and your credit cards. Change your credit card statements. And then any doctors. If you have doctors in your original state, try to switch to new ones in your new state because they want to show that you're really sincere about living there and you're actually going to the doctor there. You're not just flying home to the previous state to see your doctors. So get all your important documents in order with your new state. And join if you're involved in any religious or any other communities. Join them in the new state. Get involved down there. Make contributions to organizations that you care about that are in the new state. So be careful. Know that the IRS is tracking all these things because people are really trying to avoid paying income tax and avoid paying property taxes in the states that have high taxes, and they're moving to the other states. So get all your ducks in a row. And if you have any questions, you can reach out to us at judithheft.com. We're here to help you. We don't only do bookkeeping, we help all kinds of daily money management.